Hi there, this is David, and today I want to talk about Super Mario RPG and why it's just so great and why it stood the test of time. I first played this game back in 1996 when it first came out, and I was in high school back then. And now, over a quarter of a century later, I can still be happy to say to call it one of my favorites. So there was definitely something special here. So today, if you haven't yet played it, come with me and let's learn about it. Or if you have, you can also come and reminisce as we go ahead and look back at this classic game. But before we do begin with that, please be sure to hit that like button for the ratio, and if you're a new visitor to the channel, please be sure to subscribe for some more great content. Super Mario RPG was definitely one of those seminal game-changing RPGs, not only for me, but for the entire gaming landscape as a whole. Nowadays, we take Mario RPGs and just kind of like crossover RPGs in general for granted. But back in the 90s, stuff like this was completely unheard of. This not only ushered in the age of the mascot RPG character, but also opened up the door for more casual gamers to get into RPGs, really catapulting them to popularity in the mainstream. Let me set the stage for you. It's 1996, and the SNES is kind of waning and on its way out with the N64 on the horizon. Well, the PlayStation itself had already been out for a year, but Final Fantasy VII was still an entire year away. Really, the only RPGs over on the PlayStation at the time were Beyond the Beyond, Wild Arms, and Suikoden. And while the SNES pretty much only had Super Mario RPG and Lufia 2 on its 1996 release roster, I still personally did not have that PlayStation. I was entering my freshman year of high school, and my parents bought this game for me for my 14th birthday, and I'm telling you, I must have played it all summer long. The game was really the first of its kind, not only by using a beloved established character as the hero, but also insofar as having two powerhouse companies, Nintendo and Square, coming together to create such a memorable RPG. The only other kind of crossover that we ever received was Chrono Trigger, 2 years prior, back whenever Square and Enix came together to co-create that masterpiece. And with the success of that, Square and Nintendo decided to dip their foot into the pool by utilizing Square's RPG knowledge and then combining that with Nintendo's iconic characters and knack for fun gameplay to create a really one-of-a-kind experience. You might think that you already know what this game is all about if you've ever played like a Paper Mario or Mario & Luigi RPG, but I'm here to tell you that you don't, because those games are really nothing like this one. Super Mario RPG plays much more akin to a traditional Dragon Quest or Final Fantasy game than their spin-off Redheaded Stepchildren. And I do mean that, because this first RPG outing on the SNES blows all the rest of the other Mario RPGs completely out of the water. None of them can even hold a candle to the original. Whereas the other games do allow you to play as either the two titular brothers or as Mario and a partner, here you get to play as three full-fledged party members out of a choice of a total of five. It is much more traditional, and it plays exactly how you would think an SNES RPG should play. Or does it? Super Mario RPG expertly combines the gameplay of an isometric 2.5D Mario platformer, along with those lovingly crafted towns and dungeons, and a unique battle system that nobody had ever seen before. The strange viewpoint and platforming has its own unique quirks and characteristics all its own. First of all, whenever you're out exploring, you can jump. And while that might kind of seem like basic today, it was revolutionary back then. The only other RPGs that allow you to jump were Final Fantasy Mystic Quest and Final Fantasy Legend 3. And that was really just to kind of like jump over pits and the heads of annoying NPCs. However, here it serves an exploration purpose. Not only can you jump on the top of NPCs' heads, but you can jump up to hit the coin boxes, find treasure chests, hidden coin boxes, jump up to higher ledges, jump over monsters on the field to avoid battles, or of course even jump into the warp pipes that Mario is so well known for. Towards the end of the SNES's life cycle, RPG developers did begin putting enemies on the screen, but it wasn't anything like this. In Chrono Trigger, they were mostly static, and they kind of stuck to the little room that they were placed in. While in Lufia 2, they kind of moved randomly around the room, taking a step whenever Maxim did too. But here, the enemies move in a much more organic way. The fireballs will jump out of the lava, the Lakitus will fly around dropping enemies, the Wigglers will crawl in and out of pipes, and the Goombas will wander around looking goofy as usual. And you know how you can get like a superstar in a Mario game and just kill all the enemies that you touch? It's the same thing here. Whenever you find a star, you're gonna wanna run around like a mad plumber and knock those bitches out, getting one-hit kills on them and grabbing all that delicious experience in gold. So when that star runs out, you can just amass all your levels. It's great, and it does keep grinding to an absolute minimum. I mean, they even revolutionized something as simple as leveling. Back in the day, whenever you gained up a level, you pretty much just kind of gained the stats that the game wanted to give you. You didn't really have that much of a choice in the matter. But Super Mario RPG changed all that. Here, whenever you gain a level, you have a choice of putting points into your attack and defense, HP, or magical power. But in order to encourage you to raise well-balanced characters, one of those stats would get a bigger boost than the others, depending on the particular level up. It sounds really simple today, but back then, it was a total game changer. Then, just like any good Mario game, this has platforming elements. We had never seen anything like that in RPGs before, except maybe some like side-scrolling action RPGs like ActRaiser, because these two genres just didn't mix. But this game changed all that, as they melded together platforming and turn-based combat seamlessly. Whether it's just little things like jumping onto flowers or going on moving platforms, or whether it's more complex platforming, like climbing up the cliff at World's End or the puzzles over in Booster's Tower. Each stage feels like its own world, and it was truly unique, and it really felt like a true Mario adventure set in an RPG universe. They even took something as trite as battling, and they turned that on its head. Nowadays, we take timed attacks to be commonplace, but you might be surprised to learn that that system was first introduced here. I remember that there was an entire article about the combat in an issue of Nintendo Power, explaining how the timed attack works. It was just so new and novel. No one had ever seen anything quite like it before. Add to the fact that you could not only play as Princess Toadstool, but the titular villain Bowser. Man, we were all pumped. Then, we all wanted to learn as much as we could about the two brand new characters that were introduced, Mallow and Geno, who unfortunately have kind of like fallen off the face of the planet since their introduction, but hopefully this remake will allow for a springboard into future Mario RPGs, or maybe even into Super Smash Bros. It has been so much fun looking back at this childhood classic, and I am happy to say that while the legacy of the first game on the SNES was that of a falling out and schism developing between Square and Nintendo, the legacy of this remake is that of mutual cooperation, partnership, and friendship between the two juggernaut companies. So that's it for my little retrospective on Super Mario RPG and just talking about what an amazing, awesome game this is. So I want to ask you, did you ever play the original? And if so, how'd you feel about it? And are you excited for the remake? Let's get a discussion going on here and let's all talk and chat about it, because I'm always in the comments too. And if you like what I do here on the channel, please head on over to the Patreon to sign up for early access to my videos and behind-the-scenes photographs. The link to it is over in the video description. And as always, please like, comment, and subscribe, and have a good day.